Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple hydraulic cylinder in SOLIDWORKS. Here we will make multiple number of parts and assemble at the end. I hope you like it. So let's see this beautiful project in SOLIDWORKS. How to make in SOLIDWORKS? Now here we will make the first part of hydraulic cylinder is housing, hydraulic cylinder housing. So let's start to make. We will choose your right plane sketch and select your circle, and let's draw two circles from origin point, one and two. Select here, okay. Now select, choose the smart dimension. Okay, this selected inner one. So inner one we will make it 130, this actually 9.7 millimeter. This is in inches, we just converted in millimeter. Okay, just choose outer one 152.4 millimeter. Okay, that's it. Now simply exit and go to features and select here extruded boss base, and here end condition in direction one choose mid plane, and length we will keep 412 millimeter. That's it. Okay, now it looks a little weird, so choose your perspective. Now it looks perfect shape. Now select this part, go to appearance and paint. I'll paint this one. I'll choose some metallic gold. Go to edit appearance, and here you can choose directly yellow. See, it looks perfect, a metallic color. I like it. Okay, now let's save this one. Go to desktop, create new folder and select hydraulic cylinder. Now this is your first part, so cylinder housing. Save it. Let's see the next part. Now here let's make the next part of hydraulic cylinder, lower cap. So let's start with top plane. Choose top plane. Go to sketch and select sketch, and choose your center rectangle, and let me draw a rectangle. Right click, select. Now select both the vertical and horizontal line and create relation equal. Okay, let me choose. Now this dimension 165.1 millimeter, actually this is inches, we converted just in. Okay, now select extrude, and we want to extrude up to 38.1 inch in millimeter in upward direction, and choose direction to 2 millimeter, 2 millimeter in bottom direction. Okay, now select the top face. Let me define this material. I'll choose steel, cast steel. Cast steel plus little dark, we like to put some, not more dark, it seems too dark. Okay, now select this top face again and choose your sketch normal, and again choose center rectangle, draw a rectangle, right click, select. Now select again both the vertical and horizontal line and create relation equal. Let me define this 95.25 millimeter. Select extruded boss base. Now this one also we want to extrude up to 38.1 millimeter. Same. Okay, Now select this face, sketch, normal. Now choose here center three-point arc. Connect this point to this point and draw a half circle. See, this is half circle. And connect both the lines. If you want, you can measure it. See, this is the radius actually. Now select extruded boss base, reverse direction, choose up to vertex, and I'll choose this one corner. See how it's going to extrude. Okay, that's it. Select again this face sketch, choose here circle, and select this center point. This is the center of this upper circle, and let me keep the dimension 25.4 millimeter. This is exactly 1 inch diameter. Now select extruded cut and keep end condition here through all. You want to make throughout hole. Okay, now see, that's it. Now select this side sketch normal, and here we want to make some cutout, so let me choose corner rectangle, and I'll start from here to here, and let me define this one. I'll keep 38.1 millimeter and distance from outer line. This one we will keep, after calculation we found it 28.575 millimeter. That's it. Now select extruded cut and here select throughout. Select OK. That's it. This is what we want to like. Choose fillet, and this fillet we will keep 3.175, and select this one corner, and we will see some option. See connected to end three loop, select this one, and see all three edges will be selected automatically. Okay, that's nice. Now let select back side, so sketch, and select circle, and here we want to make a circle, and let me define this 52 millimeter and select extruded cut, and we want to keep the depth actually 36.83 millimeter. Sorry. Okay, that's it. Now again choose the same sketch normal, and here we want to create the passage for our hydraulic housing. So let me choose two circles, 1, 2. Okay, select smart dimension, and let's keep outer one 152.4 millimeter, and the inner one it's around 139.7 millimeter. That's it. Select extruded cut. Now this ring we need to cut, and we want to keep depth only 8 millimeter. Okay, now see how we create the gap depth. Now that's an okay. Now let me choose this face sketch, and select one center line, draw one center line midpoint to midpoint. Okay, this is the center line exit. Select this face and choose your hole wizard. You want to make some hole here, is choose straight tap inches. I'll is pipe tapped hole. We want to create some tapped hole, and size we will keep 1/2 inch by 14 NPSM. This is the standard. And depth, blind depth 63.5. This is okay, and this one also sufficient. Now just go to position. Select the normal position. You can see the center point of this circle. That's why we drawn this sketch. Select here, okay. Now press escape key. Now you can see the preview here. Select okay. Now we don't is not going to see here something. So what we will do, just go to option, document properties, and dimension detailing. Select here shaded cosmetic thread. Check this one. Okay, now see, you can see the cosmetic thread here. Just come bottom here. We want to connect one hole to this hole, so select this backface sketch normal hole here. So we should connect this hole here. Draw one circle. Now let's define this one 12.7 millimeter, and distance from outer line make sure 32 millimeter. Okay, and select one more relation. Select origin point and center of this circle and make relation horizontal. Now you can see this is parallel and fully defined. So select here extruded cut and keep the depth 30 millimeter. Let's check the up to where it goes. Let's keep little less so that it will not hurt in upper direction. Okay, 25 millimeter. Hide this. That's it. See, the hole is created. Now what else? Balance. And here four holes. Select this face sketch normal. Choose circle and draw one circle and select this circle for construction purpose. Okay, and define this diameter 175.26 millimeter. Okay, center rectangle, exit. Now select this all the circle lines, make relation equal, and for construction purpose select all the four lines. Choose for construction geometry circle and let me draw four circle at this point. Here we want to create a hole for fixing. Right click, select. Now select all the four circles and make relation. I'll choose one by one, all equal. Okay, and choose smart dimension and define any one circle 12.7 millimeter. Okay, and select cut through all. You can see the preview. Okay, that's it. So this is our lower cap is ready, lower cap for hydraulic cylinder. If we will keep little dark, we are not able to see the dimension. So the previous one is better. This dimension is quite better. Now let's save this one, part number 2, lower cap. Let's check other parts. Let's make the third part of hydraulic cylinder, top cover. So let's start with top. top plane sketch, and let me draw the same center rectangle. Okay, select both the lines, vertical and horizontal, keep relation equal, smart dimension, and keep the length 165.1 millimeter. Select extrude, and this time we will extrude up to 50.8 millimeter. Okay, select the top face sketch, circle, and draw one circle here. Let's keep the diameter 80 millimeter. Select extruded boss base and extrude up to 52 millimeter in upward direction. Okay, select this top face. We want to create some hole here. Sketch, circle, and let's draw a circle just smaller than this outer one. And here we will keep the depth diameter 64 millimeter. Select extruded cut and keep the depth 28 millimeter only. Okay, select the inside circle, inside face sketch, circle, and let me draw one more circle. We want to go little more depth. Keep diameter this time, keep 60 millimeter. Go to feature and select extruded cut, and this time we will keep the depth 22 millimeter. Okay, now that's it. Okay, that's fine. Choose smart dimension, keep 3.175 millimeter radius. Select one end, and a small window will pop up. Just select the first one connected to start loop three edges. See, automatically it will select all the four corners. Okay, go back, select backside sketch, and draw a circle. We want to create a hole here, and let me define this diameter 40 millimeter. Select extruded cut. We like to cut, so keep the depth 40 millimeter. Okay, again select the back surface sketch, normal. Now here we want to create a groove for hydraulic cylinder housing, so let me choose circle and draw two circles. Exit. Now choose smart dimension and keep outer one 152.4 millimeter, and the inner one 139.7 millimeter. This is the only dimension. Now select extruded cut, and we want to keep 8 millimeter depth. Okay, now see, that's it. Now let me do some more things. Select this face sketch, and here draw one center line. We want to keep some tapped hole here, so draw one center line, horizontal center line. See, exit. Select this face and choose hole wizard. I want to keep here a straight tap. We want to keep some tap inches, straight pipe tapped hole size. This is what we kept in previous part. Depth, now depth we want to change here 47.24 millimeter. Okay, 47.24 millimeter and 41.9 millimeter. Let me choose position and see the center window pop up. Click here, press escape key. Now you can see the preview here. Select OK. Now the tapped hole is created, but we are not able to see the tapped cosmetic thread here. So what we will do, just go to option, documents, property, detailing and select here shaded cosmetic thread box. Okay, now let's see. You can see the cosmetic thread here. This is not real thread, it is a cosmetic thread. Okay, so we want to connect one hole here, so select the again back surface sketch and we want to connect a hole here, so let me choose, let me define this 32 millimeter diameter, 12.7 millimeter, and select the circle center and origin point, make relation vertical. Now it's fully defined. Select extruded cut and just increase up to, do not go in upward direction, 25 millimeter is enough. Okay, that's fine. See the hole inside and hide this construction line. That's it. Now we want to create some more holes here, so what we will do, select this surface backside sketch normal, we want to make some hole, select circle, draw a circle and click here for construction purpose and diameter 175.26 millimeter, center rectangle, and this also choose for construction purpose, this rectangle. Okay, now see, now create one relation, select vertical and horizontal line and make relation equal. Now define your four circles at four corners. Now select all the four corners and create relation equal. Hold shift key and select all four circles and make relation equal. Okay, and define the diameter 12.7 millimeter. Okay, now select here extruded cut. End condition keep throughout. Okay, actually top cover consists in two parts, so the second part is only simple plate, so we will keep this one here. Select this face sketch and choose convert entity. Again select this all circles, this bigger circles, convert. Okay, this one is balance, that's it. Feature extrude. Now see, it's going to extrude, and this depth 19.05 millimeter we will keep, and here unmerge result, so that we will identify which one is different. Okay, that's it. So from here to here, we will select a hole, cast stainless steel, this dark color we will preferred. Okay, nice, it looks perfect. Let's save this one, part number 3, top cover. Next part is fog, so let me choose front plane sketch, center rectangle and draw one rectangle. Choose smart dimension and let me keep 132 millimeter, 72 millimeter feature, and select extruded boss base. Keep end condition mid plane in direction 1, and thickness we want to make it 95.25 millimeter. Okay, select this face, sketch normal, choose here 3-point arc, draw one circle, make sure touch with this body, and a radius. Now keep the radius 36 millimeter, select outer line and this radius, tangent relation, select extruded cut, choose here flip side to cut. See the arrow, it's going to cut in this direction. End condition keep through all, or it's up to you. Okay, now that's it. Now select this face, sketch normal, select corner rectangle and draw a rectangle up to here. Millimeter, 20, this dimension we will keep around 28.575 millimeter, and the distance from here to this edge 60 millimeter. Now you can see this is fully defined. Extruded cut, keep end condition in direction 1 throughout. See, that's it. Select the back surface, sketch, and here we want to create a hole first. So I'll draw a hole and I'll keep the diameter 30 millimeter, feature, and select extruded cut, keep end condition throughout. You can see the preview, it's not going to touch the other arms. Okay, again I'll choose this same face, sketch, circle, and let me draw one bigger circle. Millimeter. Okay, and select this inside circle, convert entities, extrude. Now this portion we like to extrude, and this depth we will keep 16 millimeter. Okay, this looks nice. Select this face, sketch normal, circle, draw one circle, select outer circle and this circle, make relation concentric. Now define 24 millimeter, select extruded cut, and keep end condition here throughout. Okay, now that's it, the hole is created. Now we followed each and every steps, and let's define this fork. This is the end part of hydraulic cylinder, which is going it cast steel, and this black part, so that it's looks easily. Let's save this item number 4, fork. Save. Let's go ahead for the Next part is backing seal. So choose front plane, sketch, select your circle and draw two circle for inner and outer smart dimension. And let me keep outer one, and outer one I'll keep 138 millimeter and inner one 120 millimeter. Feature, keep mid plane and thickness only 2 millimeter. Okay, and the material polished copper. Part number 5, backing seal. Here the next part is barret, which is going to fixed in fork and lower cap. So choose right plane, sketch, and here choose circle and keep the diameter 31.75 millimeter. Choose extruded boss base. In direction 1, keep end condition mid plane and length 105 millimeter. Okay, perspective, now it looks perfect. Choose chamfer, keep 2 millimeter, select this face and 45 degree. Okay, now this end we want to make some hole for ring. So let me draw one plane first. Plane, select this face, 5 millimeter flip offset, that's it. Okay, now select this plane, sketch, take the normal position and draw here two circles. One is equal to the outer one and another one is smaller than. And this one 29.75 millimeter. This is 31.75 millimeter. Now select extruded cut. Thickness only 2 millimeter. We want to cut only 2 millimeter from the inside. Okay, just hide this plane. Now you can see a groove. It is the groove where our what is circle clip going to fixed. Now let's, I want to mirror this one. So how we will do this one? Let's see any plane, right plane, mirror, and from here select extruded cut part. You can see the preview here. Features to mirror, we selected this cutout. Okay, now that's it. Let me make some color to this material. Brushed steel. Let's save part number 6, barret. It is going to fix with this lower cap and fork in this hole. Barret. Okay, save. Let's check other parts. Here is the main part of hydraulic cylinder is piston. So let's make the piston. Front plane, sketch, circle, and let me draw two circles. Outer one I'll keep 133.35 millimeter and inner one 30 millimeter. select extrude and keep end condition. We want to make 57 millimeter thick. Choose backward direction. Okay, that's nice. Let me choose plane, select this face, 3 millimeter, flip inside. Okay, select sketch this plane, plane number 1, take the normal position. First select this outer circle, convert entities. Now choose again a circle and draw one bigger circle. 146.05 millimeter. This is the outer dimension we want to keep. Now select extrude. 9 millimeter and keep blind reverse direction. You can see it's going inside. Okay. Hide this plane. Now here we want to create one axis, so choose axis, select this drum, cylindrical face. Okay, now choose linear pattern, direction, select this arrow, 21. Feature, I'll choose this one. See, select three numbers, distance 21, three numbers. You can see the preview here. Okay, that's it. Now let's hide axis 1. So this is the our piston, simple piston. We will give some good color. Let's define first material. Polished material, it's okay, but okay, let's choose this brushed steel. Save. This is the part number 7, piston. Piston rod is the next part, so let me choose front plane, sketch, circle, and draw a circle. Forty millimeter, and extrude. Keep end condition mid plane, and length we like to keep 510 millimeter. Select isometric view. Okay. Now select this face, sketch. Now here we want to make some trim, so again choose circle and inner one keep 30 millimeter. Okay, select outer one also, convert entity. See, this is converted, and select extruded cut and make the depth 36 millimeter only. And here we want to keep some cosmetic thread. Actually here should be a real thread, but we don't have that much time to create, so we will put only cosmetic thread. So how we will put cosmetic thread? Go to insert, at the bottom you will find annotation cosmetic thread. Here select the age, see, a standard inch. Okay, let's choose metric machine thread, and this one is 30 by 2, M30 by 2, up to next. Okay, now here we are not able to see the cosmetic thread, so how we will do this one? Just go to option, document properties, detailing, and select shaded cosmetic thread. Okay, now you can see how it's easy to see. Now select this face, sketch, normal, and here we want to make some cutouts, center rectangle, draw two rectangles, and let's draw the gap, 34 mm, 17 mm. So this little portion we want to cut, so select here extruded cut, select isometric view and make the depth 17 millimeter only. Okay, see, let's go the other direction, select this face, sketch, convert entity. Now see, outer circle is converted. Again choose circle and draw a 30 millimeter circle, select extruded cut and make the depth 80 millimeter. Okay, again here we want to make some cosmetic thread, so annotation, cosmetic thread, I'll choose this edge. Now see, metric, it is already selected here, M 30 by 2 inch, 2 millimeter up to next. Okay, now it's visible here. Let's define some material so that, okay, this looks better. Satin finish, stainless steel, and feature, insert feature and dome, both the end will put some dome shape, 2 millimeter, and select this two faces. Okay, let's save this part, part number 8, piston rod. That's it. Next part is tension bolt. Choose here front plane, sketch, circle, and draw a circle, and let's keep the diameter 12.7 millimeter. This is a kind of bolt extrude. Now keep end condition mid plane and length 536 millimeter, isometric view. Okay, now in both the end we want to create, first go to option, document property, detailing, and select here shaded cosmetic thread. Okay, now try insert, annotation, cosmetic thread. Actually here should be a real thread, but we are choosing some this edge we selected. Choose your inches, machine thread, okay, half by 20 inch, and blind the depth, how much the depth we like, actually 44.5 millimeter. Okay, the same thing we have to do this side, insert, annotation, cosmetic thread. Even you can choose a face also, select this face. Okay, let's choose this corner. ...44.5 millimeter, NC inches, thread half by 20 inch. Okay, that's it. Now it's time to add some better to add some dome shape. Two millimeter. Okay, select apply some material, satin finish stainless steel mat. If we choose matte, it looks little dark. Okay, let's choose polished steel. Okay, let's keep polished steel. Save. Tension bolt. Let's make the tension bolt nut top plane. Now choose here polygon and keep parameter 6 in scarf circle. Exit. Now select this side line and make relation vertical. That's it. This one actually 1 inch nut, so 25.4 inch. Now select extrude, keep 10 millimeter mid plane. Select this face and make a hole here. .7 millimeter extruded cut and keep end condition through all and add some cosmetic thread. Inches keep 9 by 16, this is perfect. Up to next, go to option documents property and detailing and select here this, check this box, shaded cosmetic thread. Okay, now you can see the thread. Now here let's make some chamfer. So select this face, sketch circle, and draw one circle up to this outer edge. Select extruded cut. Here choose flip side to cut, keep through all, keep angle keep 60 degree only. Okay, now see, choose top plane, mirror, and select this face. See feature to mirror. Okay, now it's mirror. So this is our nut, this is our tension bolt nut. We will assign some dark color. Save. Part number 10, tension bolt nut. Save. Here the next part is piston seal. So let's start with front plane, sketch center line. Let me draw a center line. Exit, choose your line, convert it into arc, and connect. Exit. Now let's make some relation. Select these two lines, collinear and equal. Okay, select this line and arc tangent. Actually it should be tangent relation. Okay, let's check this one. 6 millimeter, 12 millimeter, 3 millimeter. Okay, 12 millimeter. Six millimeter. Six millimeter and 1 line from three millimeters, so it will be calm. Parallel relation, the same here, it's parallel. 3 point arc and touch with this point, exit. Now select this line and point, tangent relation, the same here, tangent. It's already tangent, by default is tangent. Now this is your perfect shape of seal. And one more thing, the distance. This is your main distance of seal, 67.31 millimeter. This is our roughly calculated seal revolve boss base. Select this line as axis of revolution. Okay, go to material, matte rubber. Let's So this is the simple seal, piston seal. So let's save this one, 11 point piston seal 1. Now here make the second seal, front plane sketch. Draw here 2 circles. Smart dimension 65 and inner one 60 millimeter, and extrude. Keep end condition mid plane. Thickness keep 6 millimeter. Okay. Material choose. Actually, if we will choose light material, then. Okay, let's keep this one as it is. 12 seal 2. Let's check one more part. Here the next part is rod guide, front plane sketch. The rod guide, it is made by rubber, so draw the same, a kind of bush actually. 60 by 40, inner 40 millimeter, and extrude 28 millimeter, and keep end condition mid plane. Okay, and select the same rubber mat, texture mat, textured rubber. No, that's Thirteen rod guide seal. A rod guide, you can say enough. Here the next part is piston rod nut. So let me choose front plane, a sketch. Okay, let me choose polygon. Exit. Select any one wall, horizontal, vertical relation, and let me define 45 millimeter. Now extrude, and extrude this one up to let me say 20 millimeter. Okay. Now let's choose right plane, a sketch, normal. Select here line. Convert it into arc and connect. Exit. Now define this one 12 millimeter. Choose fillet. Keep radius 0.5 millimeter and select this corner. Okay. Now choose smart dimension. Select the origin point and this center point 31.95 millimeter. This is the roughly calculated dimension, not big deal. Select revolve boss base. Select this line as the axis of revolution. See blind 360 degree merge. Okay, now see, it's going to create a sketch. Let me create a bigger up to this. Select extruded cut. Here select flip side to cut. Keep angle 60 degree. Okay, now see the outside outer edges cut. A sketch. Let's make the hole 30 millimeter and select here extruded cut and keep end condition through all. Okay, and let me choose some cosmetic thread. Okay, this 12 up to next option, documents, properties, detailing, shaded cosmetic thread. Okay, that's it. So this is your piston rod nut, and let's define this material, metal, polished metal. This is, it will suit much. This also looks brushed steel. Let's save this number, part number 14, polished rod nut. Here the next part is nut guide rod. So let's start with front plane sketch and choose here a circle, and let's keep the diameter 65 millimeter and extrude up to 42 millimeter. Okay, choose here insert annotation cosmetic thread. Select this edge, inches. Choose metric, M64x4 blind 25. Okay, now let me choose your document property, detailing, shaded cosmetic thread. Okay, that's fine. Now again choose the same space, sketch, convert entity, circle, and keep this one 60 millimeter. Select extruded cut offset 28 millimeter. Reverse and 3 millimeter we like to cut. This is also keep reverse. Okay, now see how we created a groove here. Select this face, sketch, normal, choose polygon, select this outer edge, vertical, this line and this tangent relation, select extrude 14 millimeter reverse direction. Okay, that's it. Okay, choose fillet, keep 2 millimeter, select this edge and select this edge. It will select automatically all the edges. Choose chamfer 2 millimeter and select this edge. Okay, that's it. Now sketch, choose your circle and draw one hole. Keep 42 millimeter, extrude, keep end condition through all. Okay, now the whole body we will make in copper. Let's save this part. This is the part number 15, nut, guide, rod. This is the nut for guide rod. Save. Now let's start to make assembly for hydraulic cylinder. Let's start to create the assembly of hydraulic cylinder. Choose here file, new, and select assembly. Okay, now this is the SolidWorks assembly window. Now in your left hand side it is asking you begin assembly, so just select here browse and bring our first part. So I'll keep my first part lower cap. Let's change the background. Okay, we will keep like this. Insert second part top cover. Let me rotate this part. Like this. We have a nut here. Float, rotate. Okay, now select fixed. Now see, this both hole should be in one direction. Choose mat, select these two faces, make relation concentric. These two faces coincident, not concentric, this coincident relation we created. Let's browse our next part, cylinder and backing seal. Choose cylinder and backing seal. Actually backing seal should be made with rubber, not copper, so just go back and select material, rubber, cancel. It will ask you save, select yes. Now here And let's first take the position, rotate component. Okay, press control key and copy mat. Select the circular face and this circular face, make relation concentric, coincident relation, take it out, this outer face and its outer face, because this is a kind of rubber seal, so it will going to block the oil exploration. Okay, now see, the same thing we have to do it for this inner and inner coincident relation, concentric relation. Let's take it out. Okay, do one thing, select the back face and this. Okay, seal should be comes out. Now let's, it's time to create some important relation. Select this face and this circular face, make concentric relation. Select the inside face and select this inside face, coincident relation. Okay, take back this wall and this inside groove, coincident relation. Okay, that's fine. Now we will browse some more component. Choose here piston rod and piston. This one keep like this. Select mat, select this hole and this rod, select this side wall and this side wall, coincident relation, select OK. Let's browse rod nut, press control key and piston seal. Let's rotate the nut mat. Concentric relation, take it out. Back side of nut. Okay, now it's time for seal. Select this outer ring and this concentric relation. Okay, now select this side wall and this side wall, coincident relation. That's it. Press control key, select this part and drag. Let's rotate this part. Okay, select circular face mat and any circular face, creates collinear concentric relation, outer face and this side face, coincident relation. Now the piston seal is fixed, piston seal and nut, everything is fixed. actually hole supposed to be should be side, but okay, let's keep hole in upward direction so that insert some more component, choose this nut guide, rubber guide and seal. Let me rotate. Concentric relation. Select this outer one and this one. Okay. Now concentric relation. Okay, now let's choose the inside face. And this side face, see, it's going to fix inside. Okay, now select this top face and this face, make it flip. Okay, select circular concentric relation. Okay, now make some parallel relation. Okay, that's it. Select rod and this hole, make relation concentric, just drag outside and inside. Here also we will create one more relation, parallel relation, and let's check some more parts. This one, let me rotate. It should be like this. Choose mat, select these two faces, keep relation parallel. Okay, now select this face and this concentric relation, this face and this wall, coincident relation. Now this is fixed here, piston, see. Now let me choose some browse some more component. Pin. Mat. Concentric relation. And choose here one more advanced relation, width. Select these two side of select here also two sides. Okay, press control key and copy one more item. We need to fix to the other end. Concentric relation, just go to advanced mat, choose width relation. Now this one is created. And just choose browse, tension bolt and tension nut. Nut, bolt. Let's keep align, rotate. Now we need to fix this one. So open part and delete the dome relation. Okay, yes, yes, okay. Now choose mat, select this hole and rod, make relation concentric and go to advanced mat, choose width, select these two faces and this rod two faces, select OK. Standard mat concentric relation. Okay, select this side wall and this. Okay, now press control key, copy. Choose mat concentric relation, select this side face. Okay, now let's make multiple number of patterns for this. To choose circular pattern, select this bolt and a nut, and here choose any one circular face and choose 360 degree equal spacing, 4 number of patterns. Okay, see, now our design is not look perfect, so we need to do some modification. So first piston rod, I don't know, it not look perfect. Chrome, I'll try some chrome finish. Chrome finish also not look brushed chrome. Yes, now see the piston look little shiny, that's better. And the drum, we will try some color, some solid color, steel, brushed steel, yellow. Oh, that's also not good, but this look metallic. What do you think? Or you can simply apply it some solid color like yellow. Uh, You can make it little at least. Or let's keep yellow. Okay, because it looks a little dark. Open. Select the part. Little dark. Now it's become little dark. Now here, see, this is inlet and outlet port. Ambient. Now see, now here we need to create some relation. That's it. Go to mat, advanced mat, and here choose distance. The maximum distance, choose this face and this face. Maximum distance, let's say 150, and minimum 0.5. Let me open maximum. No, maximum is it will be more. So come down, mat, and delete this relation. Take it out. This will be your maximum opening. So let evaluate. Measure, select this face and this face, and you will find one center distance, normal distance. This is your main distance, 268.26. So we will keep 268 maximum. Mat. Advanced mat, choose width. Now select this one face, this two face, and here select 268 maximum and minimum 1 millimeter. Okay, select okay. Now let's try to open. That's it. Now it's not going beyond this. Not going beyond this, not going beyond this. So this is the limit we applied to the piston. So let's save this assembly. Hydraulic. Cylinder assembly. So don't forget to share and like our video. If you have any comment, just write down below. I'll try to answer each and every question. And please guys, share our video, which help us to do more and more in SolidWorks. If you want to do any new project, just come to our channel. You will find multiple number of projects here. I hope you like this. Thanks for watching.